r/AskReddit, what's the worst accident you had at school? In third grade, I thought it would be a brilliant idea to show off my jump rope skills by jumping down the stairs with it. Spoiler, I did not stick the landing. I ended up with a twisted ankle and my pride in pieces, surrounded by horrified classmates. The worst part? The school nurse gave me an ice pack and told me to walk it off. I limped around the rest of the day like I was auditioning for a pirate movie. My classmate dropped unconscious in gym class and was rushed to the hospital. 3 days later they took him off life support and he died from a brain aneurysm. We had some asshole take a shit down the staircase hitting all three floors on the way. I didn't know this, but apparently poop can legally be classified as a biological weapon. The school had to be shut down for 3 days and the State Bureau of Investigation got called in. I heard the term bioterrorism get thrown around. Oh man, one time I slipped on a banana peel in the cafeteria and launched my tray like a frisbee. Still traumatized. But at least it was funny. One time I tripped in front of the whole class and knocked over a stack of papers. It was like a mini waterfall of homework, but hey, at least I was memorable. Tripping on your own shoelaces in the hallway and pretending it was on purpose to save yourself from embarrassment. Classic. Tried to impress my crush by jumping down the stairs. Broke my ankle instead. Smooth AF grinning face with sweat. Oh, maybe the worst accident I had at school was in gym class, probably around 8th grade. We were playing soccer, and I was going all in, trying to impress a boy that I had a crush, you know? Anyway, I went to kick the ball, but totally misjudged it and ended up slipping on the grass. I fell super awkwardly, and my ankle just twisted in the worst way. I heard this pop, and I swear, I thought I broke it. Turns out it was just a bad sprain, but the worst part was I couldn't walk properly for like a week, and I had to use crutches. Not to mention, I had this huge bruise that went up my leg. Super embarrassing, especially cause everyone saw me go down like that. Grinning face with sweat. We're playing tag and one of my classmates decided to run on high place. We usually sit here, but he decided it's a good idea to run there. It was quite narrow, so it's not really a good idea. He misstepped and fell. Got his lips popped and it needed stitches. And yeah, blood everywhere. Apparently I walked face first into the same streetlight leaving on a school trip and coming back into school from said trip. I say apparently because others say I did it on the way out of school and on the way back, but I only remember doing it on the way back. At first grade I thought peeing and pooping at the same time was cool at the class. Couple of teenagers were clowning around in the school parking lot. One kid put a skateboard in bed of his friend's truck. He gets on the skateboard, and the friend starts driving the truck. I guess they were planning to surf around on the skateboard, in the back of the truck. Skateboards have wheels. As the truck moves forward, the kid on the skateboard is stationary, due to wheels rolling in tandem with the platform below. The tailgate sweeps the kid's legs, he tumbles out of the truck, and strikes his head on the pavement. Unfortunately, he did not survive. I can only imagine the emotional whiplash those kids felt between their juvenile horseplay to everything that happened after. It was a bad time for everyone involved. A migraine attack that made me pass out between buildings. My son just pissed his pants on the way to school an hour ago. He's 4 and it's his first time doing that. Ask this guy. I pissed myself so bad it ran down my leg and I was wearing shorts. LMAO, teacher wouldn't let me go cuz bathroom break had been 20 minutes prior, but I didn't have to go then, so I just went in my chair. Not too traumatic, but always makes me cringe. A kid in elementary school when we had those giant trampolines, remember those? They were folding it up and his arm got wedged. He panicked and pulled it out. The trampoline kept his skin. I dislocated my elbow playing lacrosse in gym during high school. My arm doesn't straighten 25 years later. Broken ankle at wrestling practice. Got knocked over by a larger kid and ended up scraping my hand and knee open on the ground on the tarmac of the playground. Our school didn't have a nurse, so the principal ended up having to personally drive me to the hospital to get stitches. That was in primary school. In secondary school, I almost got sent home because some dumbass kicked a football down the packed hallway with so much force that when it caught me in the chest, it sent me to the ground. Probably running into the window, cracking my head open, or maybe the hot glue gun burns, falling of the monkey bars was pretty wicked too. When I was in third grade, I was being an idiot on the swings trying to be funny or whatever. Under the swings were those awful wood chips. Needless to say, I ended up falling off the swings backwards and busted my head open down to the skull on a particularly sharp wood chip. I didn't even feel the cut, but I felt that the back of my head was wet and assumed it must have been mud. I just kept wiping and wiping but couldn't get it all off. When I looked at my hands, they were a dark crimson red. My buddy nearby was near and I didn't even say anything, just turned my hands towards him and he said, "Dude, go tell a teacher." Got some staples in the back of my head out of that one. Fell face first in sand hanging from monkey bars. Messed up my face pretty bad, it still hasn't recovered. My classmates, girl, hairs got stuck in the sleeve buttons of my blazer, the whole class was laughing along with the teacher. Probably the most embarrassing moment of my life till now. So, not during the school year, but I worked a summer program at the school helping the janitors. It was lawn mowing day, so they filled garbage cans with clippings and another guy and myself dumped them in the dumpster. Some construction company had taken out a wall and dumped the concrete in the front of the dumpster. The weight of the barrel of clippings on the lip getting ready to dump was enough to make the dumpster fall over. The concrete shifted so it did not go back up once the weight was removed. It had landed on my foot and trapped my toes. The other guy ran for help when we couldn't possibly lift it ourselves. Adrenaline kicked in and I was able to pull my foot out from under it alone if I left behind my shoe, my sock, and a couple of toenails. Nothing broken, but very bloody. Several people told me if I had worn steel toes, there was a non-zero chance I would have lost toes as heavy as it was. It took a forklift to lift the dumpster back upright and recover my shoe/axe/etc. Oh, during school? Aside from getting tripped running full speed and banging my knee on the hard clay ground that might as well have been brick in the summer heat and needing stitches, nothing really bad has happened to me at school. I was far more prone to emotional damage in school than physical. In health class, sophomore year of high school, I accidentally gave myself a concussion after facepalming too hard. I couldn't remember much until a female classmate told me that I busted my nose during the process. Luckily, that same classmate explained what led up to me being in the nurse's office. We were being shown different forms of protection if someone would to have sex. Yes, my school taught sex education with the discussion on if we gave in, we might as well do it safely. It was considered part of the health courses that was mandatory for both freshmen and sophomore students. Anyhow, to cut a long story, I gave myself a nosebleed and a concussion after a male classmate was making a joke about Jews while wearing a clean condom on his head. He was trying to get a laugh. My nosebleed looked like something straight from an anime. Shit my pants in pee. Blue pen went off before a meeting with bigwig C-level mentors in college. Fortunately I had time, restroom soap were very good. A combination of hot water, rough paper towel and soap for 30 minutes got most of it out. Fingernails were still bluish. Everyone probably noticed but no one said a thing. In third grade, I learned that canned pears made me violently ill. I ran to leave the cafeteria to get to the bathroom before I spewed, but didn't make it. Not only did I vomit, but so did most everyone else in the cafeteria. The janitor had to clean up after us all. I haven't had a pair since that fateful day. It's the mid-80s and I'm staying late after school programming the skier game on a K-Pro 8086 PC. If you're old enough to remember, the game involved using your arrow keys to navigate the capital H letter in between a randomly changing course of exclamation marks on the screen. The final 10 minutes of my effort was spent holding back my raging waters. However, when I eventually stood up, the spillway opened, releasing the emergency thigh-crushed penis dam. No one saw the actual spillage, but they definitely witnessed my walk of shame. Bare-chested, with a shirt pulled up over my shorts to hide my soggy bottoms, was the longest 2-mile hike of my life. In grade 10, I squirted a girl in the cafeteria with a water bottle. She hit me in the face with her windbreaker, scratching my cornea. Had to wear an eye patch for a week or two. During my 9th grade year, I was in a different school and it was in Little Rock, Arkansas. I have made friends with one of my classmates who was in the football team, basketball team, baseball team, any sport that the school had, he was in it, and he was the captain or co-captain in the sports. And at that time, a big test was going around, and not only that, there been multiple fights during a whole week. On the end of the test day, last of it, there was a huge fight brawl in the hallways. The fights were so bad they had to get involved with police and the sheriff in Little Rock as well, state troopers. I was walking down the hall to go to my class and I had witnessed the same friend I had to explain on here dropped kicked a cop, and it was not a regular cop or sheriff or even the state troopers. It was, and I'm not lying or making this up, it was the sheriff state trooper of Arkansas who is trying to break the fight apart that happens to be my friend involved, and he dropped kicked him, knocked him out. Bad enough that ambulance had to get involved to take the sheriff state trooper to the hospital, and my friend was tossed and handcuffed and was sent to the police after they called their mother to pick him up and bail him. Now I'm 23 years old and I still in contact with him. He told me afterwards, since I left and everything, he changed better, and he said that he still regretted what he did to that dude from what he knew, that after he was sent to the hospital his throat was closed after that combat from him drop kicking him and knocking him out. They had to put a tube down his throat to get him to breathe, and that cop is now retired. He's all healed and everything. It was not like major injuries or such, because they got it on time before it was too late, and my friend decided to go to him and his family to apologize because he was the heat of the moment and he didn't know better. And from what I knew him, that cop or buddies talk about sports and going out to drinks being buddies, and he did had a record, but charges were dropped after investigating the reason behind and everything. The other kid got arrested for it, of starting the fight and making him do that to the cop. And last, from what I heard from my friend, that now he's married and now he's going to have kids soon, and I am proud of him. And not only that, he changed better for himself and made friends with the sheriff state trooper who retired. I was walking across the top of a row of outdoor benches and my toe caught on one of them. I fell forward onto the concrete with all my weight on one knee. Cracked my patella in half. 35 years later and I can tell when it's going to rain because my knee aches like a bitch. I was in gym class and accidentally kicked the soccer ball right into the teacher's face. The look on their face was priceless. Thankfully I didn't had accident at school. But I had a classmate before that, he broke his wrist because he fell down in stairs. Third grade, was running a race across the pavement while looking down. Looked up a split second before smashing into another kid who was running and looking behind him. He was the lucky one, because my face slammed into the back of his neck. I fell straight back and hit my head on the pavement. We went in from recess and I was hysterically crying. We went into art class and the teacher wouldn't let me go to the nurse. A friend of mine yelled at her, "Are you serious? Look at her face." Yeah, I had a concussion and my mom had to come get me. You're lucky I didn't puke on your art table, MRS. Pollock. In third grade, my friend and I were jumping out of the swings. The swing set was kind of on a hill, so if you jumped out on the downhill side you could really catch some air. Well, the swing twisted as I jumped, and launched me halfway to the moon, it felt like. I did not land on my feet. As I was getting up and brushing the dirt off, trying to catch my breath, I caught sight of my friend's face. She looked like face screaming in fear. I'm like, what? And she just said, your arm. I held it up and it was like a big gooseneck or you between my elbow and wrist. We both took off running and screaming to the teachers on recess duty. The pain didn't hit until later. I had shattered both bones in my forearm. I spent 7 weeks in a cast, and I have a scar to this day. I don't really remember it too much, but in preschool I fell off some stone bench and cracked my skull open. Had to get staples in my head. Thanks for watching. Leave a like if you have enjoyed this video and subscribe to never miss an upload.